Hi, my name is Satish. Okay, in this video, I am going to be discussing how to develop the RESTful service application by using JERSI. How to develop the RESTful web service application by using JERSI implementation. Okay, in the last video, already discussed about what RESTful web service introduction and what are the implementations are there. So, in this, I am only focusing on JERSI implementation. Okay, so to develop RESTful web services, we have which API? JAX RS API. For JAX RS API, we have which implementation? JERSI implementation. Yeah, so now I am going to be using the JERSI implementation. So in this video, especially I will introduce the steps. What are the steps required to develop the project by using JERSI implementation? Just before coming to that one, here, JERSI implementation is given by JAX RS API. The JERSI implementation is given by JAX RS API. Okay, the JERSI implementation is now used to develop RESTful services in Java platform. The current version of the JERSI implementation is 2.26. This is a current version of JERSI implementation. It supports JAX RS 2.1 version. Okay, the old version, that is 2.25, this is supports JAX RS API 2.0 version. So JERSI very latest version 2.26, it is supporting to work with the JAX RS 2.1. JAX RS current version is also be 2.1. JERSI 2.25, it is supporting to work with JAX RS 2.0 version. It's okay. So, this is a JERSI implementation. So, now concentrate. What are the steps actually required to develop the project by using JERSI implementation? That is my main focus. So, now I am coming to the steps. If you wanted to develop the RESTful service application by using JERSI implementation, okay, what are the steps required? The first step is create root resource class. The first step is create root resource class. Okay, first the steps headings understand. Step 2 is create resource methods. Step 3 is configure JERSI provided servlet in web.xml file just like a normal servlet. Then step 4 is deploy the project into the server. Okay. So, to develop the RESTful service application by using JERSI, what are the steps required? First, create root resource class. Then, after create resource method. Then, after configure the JERSI provided servlets in the web.xml. Then, directly deploy the project into the server. Okay. Here, to develop the root resource class, and this resource methods, to develop the root resource class and resource methods, we can use some annotations. Those annotations are not given by JERSI. Those annotations are provided by JAX RS API. Okay, so to create the root resource class and the resource methods, some annotations required. Those annotations are given by JAX RS API. Okay, so my point is, actually, even though you are using JERSI, REST EASY, RESTlet, any implementation, these two steps are same. Creating of root resource and resource methods, these two are same, because these two we are developing by using the API given annotations, that is JAX RS API given annotations. So, because of that reason, these two are not changing. Only the servlet is changing from one implementation to another implementation. But this creating of root resource methods are same even though we are using any implementation. Okay, now how to develop the root resource? Actually, what is root resource? Now concentrate. I am coming to the root resource. Root resource is a web service in simple manner. The root resource is exposing the data over the network. Exposing the data over the network. Okay. Web service main goal is what? Web service main goal is expose the data over the network. So in the RESTful, we will use the terminology as root resource. So the root resource is specially exposing the data over the network. The root resource is accessing by the client over the network through URL. So every root resource is depending on which one? URL only. Okay. Now how to develop root resource class? Okay. For example, I am taking one simple Java class, public class, product service. I am taking one simple Java class, the class like product service. Okay, now right now it is not a root resource. Right now it is a simple Java class. Now I want to make this simple Java class. I want to make this simple Java class as a root resource class. So how to make this simple Java class as a root resource class? Now observe, to make this simple Java class as a root resource class, the class denote with @path annotation. The class denote with @path annotation. Okay, @path annotation not given by JRC implementation. @path annotation is given by JAX-RS annotation, JAX-RS API. So even though you are using any implementation, these annotations are same. So which class is actually called root resources? If any Java class that is denoted with @path annotation, then that class is acting as a root resource that is exposing the data over the network. Is okay, the path when we are using @path annotation, when we are using, it is required to be provide some URL, because the RESTful web services depending on URL, the RESTful services are accessing by the client through URL. For example, here I am writing like products, and it is not mandated to start with slash. Even though you are starts with slash, even though you are not starts with slash, it is acting same. Okay. So when you are using some @path annotation, you can provide some URL. So now a client can access this root resource based on that URL. How? For example, HTTP, RESTful services are exposing the data over the HTTP protocol, HTTP:// Okay. For example, here if it is deployed on local system, localhost:// some Tomcat port number like 8080 slash context path of your application slash your root resource. The root resource is what? Products. So this is a URL using by, this is a URL using by client to access which one? This root resource over the network. Okay. So every root resource is accessing by the client in the same manner. Now the first step in the application development is what? Root resource. Okay, which class is acting as a root resource? If any class that is denoted with @path annotation, then that is acting as a root resource. Okay, the root resource class contain what? Resource methods. Resource methods are nothing but web service methods. Okay. So now I am coming to the resource method. How to create a resource method? Public. For example, here I am taking the method like product. Okay, search product like this. Okay, in this example, I am not focusing any input. Okay, just only to understand the steps, I am taking very basic example. And here I am not focusing any input data. That's why I am taking a zero argument method. I am only focusing on output data. So now this is not a resource method right now. It is a simple Java method. Now we required we make this one as a web service method. That means a resource method. So how to make this one as a resource method? Okay, actually JAX RS API is given the annotations like at the rate of get, at the rate of post, at the rate of put, at the rate of delete. So like the annotations are given by JAX RS API. These annotations are called as request method designator annotations or resource method designator annotations. Request method designator annotations or resource method designator annotations. So at the rate of get, to at the rate of post, to at the rate of put, to at the rate of delete, these are called as what? Request method designator annotations or resource method designator annotations. Okay, so actually how to make one Java method as a web service method? If we are denoting any Java method by using any one of the request method designator annotation, then the Java method is acting as a resource method. Then that is also available on the network, that is accessing by the client through HTTP protocol. Okay, for example, here I am using at the rate of get, at the rate of get. So here now at the rate of get I used, means my Java method I denoted with what? A request method designator annotation, that rate of get. So now it is acting as a web service method. Okay, this is accessing by the client by using HTTP protocol get request. Okay, why HTTP protocol get request is using? As here the method already denoted with what? Get. For example, if the method denoted with post, the client can access this resource method by using HTTP protocol post request. Okay, so if any method that is denoted with the request method designator annotation, then that method is acting as a resource method. It's okay. So to make one simple Java class as a resource class, we can use at the rate of path, and to make one simple Java method as a resource method, we can denote with at the rate of get. Next, I wanted to expose this product data over the network in a specific media type, the specific media type like XML or JSON. Means I wanted to give the product object data to client in the form of a specific media type in the like XML or JSON. Actually, what is the need to give in the form of specific media type is, now we are the service provider, application now we are developing with Java, but client application, Java application or .NET application or PHP application or any mobile application, there is no guarantee. So the client application designed by using which technology, there is no guarantee. So here, to understand our response data by any client application, we required we use either XML or JSON. So that's why I wanted to produce this product object data in the form of a specific media type. So to produce this response data in a specific media type, here the method denote with produces annotation. The method denote with the produces annotation and write the required MIME type, that means media type. For example, here I am writing application/JSON. Then what happens is the product object data is converting into JSON, and on the network the product object data transferring in the form of JSON. So client not receiving directly product object, the client will receive product object data in the form of JSON. For example, here if I am using the producers with the media type of application/XML, then the client will get this product object data in the form of XML. So based on our media type, the RESTful service will produce this result value to which one? Client. So even though client is any technology application, there is no problem. Okay, so producers, based on the producers annotation, my Java object is producing in the form of specific media type. So just now, okay, I introduce a root resource and a resource method. One more, resource method level also, resource method level also possible to provide the URL. So resource method level also, if you wanted to provide the URL, again we can use resource method level also, the annotation at the rate of path. For example, here I'm using the path is, here writing of slash is optional, search product like this. So how client can access now? Now client can access context path slash product slash search product by using this one. The client will send the request and the client will access this product data in the form of this XML. Okay, so like we can develop the root resource and what resource methods. Okay, so what are the steps required? First step is create the root resource class. Second step is create the resource methods. Here just only I introduced three annotations, at the rate of path, at the rate of get, at the rate of producers. Okay, so next, what is the third step? Configure the jersey provider servlet in the web.xml file, just like a normal servlet. Okay, now here I'm introducing one important point. The jersey is having two versions, 1.x and 2.x. When we are working with the jersey 1.x version, okay, we can configure the following servlet in web.xml file. What is that one? com.sun.jersey.spa.container.servlet. It is a package name. The class name is servlet container. When you are working with jersey 2.x version, then we can configure arg.glassfish.jersey.servlet.servlet container. Actually, class name same, but package name is different from jersey 1.x version to jersey 2.x. For example, according to jersey 1.x, now observe, your root resource class develop, resource methods develop over, then after what we require? web.xml file. So configure that servlet in the web.xml just like a normal servlet. How we'll configure? Web app, close the web app, then servlet, close the servlet, your servlet name, servlet name is any name, for example jersey, servlet name, servlet class, the servlet class is the servlet container, actually your class name is servlet container. Next, servlet class, whenever you are configuring the servlet, it's always a good practice to configure load and startup also. Why? If you are not configuring any load and startup, servlet object will create just before processing the first request. If you are providing load and startup, servlet object will create at the time of deploying our project into the server. So to create our servlet object at the time of deploying the project on the server, here I am configuring load and startup. Okay, load and startup value, like I'm using one. So next, servlet ready with the servlet mapping. Now I'm going to be linking servlet mapping. Okay, close which one? Servlet mapping. Next, here I want which one? Servlet name. Next, it is required what? URL pattern. Okay, for example, slash star, close URL pattern. So like, okay, what is slash star? It is called directory match URL pattern. The directory match URL pattern, I'm indicating what, any request coming from client starts with slash can handling by this servlet. So if you want to develop a project by using jersey, just these are the three steps just to use. After that, deploy the project into the server. So what are the steps here I used? First I created the root resource, next create a resource method, then configure the jersey provided servlet in web.xml file just like a normal servlet. After that, just deploy the project into the server. It's okay. So in the next video, I will introduce this application, how to implement practically. Okay, just in this video only I discussed what steps, but in the next video I will show how to implement this application practically. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to Naresh Shetty YouTube channel.